Ah, mustaches. Okay. Liz hasn't clocked on yet, though. You have. I made you do that on purpose. They can't hear you yet. Hang on, let me. They can.
What?
No, they can.
Okay. Hi.
Hello. Hello. Welcome to Makeup with Maaerys.
Yeah. Sorry, but really, welcome to Makeup with Maaerys. I just thought it would be fun to start to like feature the wonderful members of our cast each week in a little live pre-stream show where we just kind of hang and talk about what has happened in the campaign thus far, and also in last time's actual meeting, because that was like 2 weeks ago now. So yay! Yeah. Happy 2021. I hope everyone is surviving and thriving.
Something like that.
If you're not thriving, I hope you're surviving. So yeah, I am gonna do my makeup while we talk about what's gone on up until this point. And feel free to like hop on chat, ask any questions. Elena, aka Claire, is gonna be running questions for me because I can't, I mean, I could look at the chat and do this, but it would be a different kind of experience.
Focus on one thing at a time, darling. It's fine.
They'd probably both be entertaining in their own way, but yeah. One would be a disaster.
I need to do a quick check and I'll be right back.
Okay, great. Cool. Okay, well then, Jade, you can answer a question for me.
I can answer questions when they get asked. Or I can ask you the questions if they get asked.
Okay, but I can, like, can I ask you a question right now?
Yep.
Great. So, Elimus, is he human or a half elf?
He's human.
Fuck! I thought you were like not fully human.
Did you not know that?
No, I forgot. I knew you were at least half human. So I mean, I misrepresented you a little bit.
You thought I was half elf?
Yeah.
Really? All this time, like, level 10.
Okay, level 90 for me. Thank you so much.
Oh yeah, level 90.
Yeah, level 90. Okay, well, that clears that up for me. Great, cool. Yeah, so, great. What I'm doing right now is I'm putting blue shit on my eyes, as you can see. And for those of you who want to try this, like, super fun look, it starts with what?
We've got people watching. So,
oh, great.
Tam, what was your question?
Oh, awesome.
And hello, Pixie.
Hi, Pixie.
We'll have other people here soon.
Okay.
And Manx. Welcome, Manx.
Hello.
Liz, we can see a bogey up your nose.
Oh, no.
back.
Wait, do we have a question?
No. He says, I was making a sarcastic comment. Sorry for the confusion.
Oh, my God.
I was doing other stuff because I'd spelt something wrong in the title, so I was fixing that.
Fair enough.
How horrible.
Okay, so let's talk about what's been going on. How are you handling things, Claire? How you doing? Elena, Claire.
You're out of character because those are two very different but also very similar questions.
I say both.
Okay. So... Elena is refreshed after a vacation.
Yay! Way to go!
My husband and I quarantined and then went and visited family in Wisconsin. And it was amazing to like just not have anything to worry about for like a week and a half. And Christmas was dope. New Year's was dope. And, you know, then I came home and then, like, shit massively hit the fan here. So, I have a lot of mixed feelings about it.
Aww.
Most of them go, like, between like what the flying fuck and ah.
Fair enough. That seems like a, you know, a good mm-hmm. place to be, an appropriate response.
Yeah. Oh, there's a question for you in chat.
Oh, goody.
Do you have theater experience as well, Maaerys?
I do have theater experience, which I'm sure comes as a surprise to no one.
Not at all.
As I seem like a theater person, I believe. But, sorry, I have to readjust. I need my Zoom Innie mirror. So I don't like... I do. I have theater experience. I grew up like doing musical theater, and like wanted to go to Broadway. And then, I mean, now
on Broadway,
on Broadway. But now I do opera. So the opera stage is my theater now. Yeah.
Pixie says, theater, who's she?
Yeah, who's she? We don't, none of us probably, you know, who enjoy D&D or live role play games.
We're,
like,
we're not into that shit at all.
No, it's make-believe. Also, for those of you who are wondering, this is the palette I'm using.
That is
rainbow. Isn't it amazing?
Shiny.
It's the Fade into Hue ColourPop palette.
I have to say, your... like color shading is dope. That is not something I am capable of doing. Like, give me a palette of like neutral colors and maybe some purple and I'm like, I'm competent. Anything beyond that is a fucking shit show. I look like a clown.
Oh no. Well, your makeup always looks really good. But if you
it
wanted to like
practice.
Well, you know, just keep practicing. But so like the trick to blending is that you start by like collecting pigment and like these shadows. I also started with this palette, Sugar Crystals by Violet Voss. But I started with this color
not
and it's
sponsored
like,
by.
Yeah, not sponsored by. Violet
no
Voss.
One, no one's
where are
giving
you?
Us money.
ColourPop. not sponsored yet. No, I'm just kidding. But so this is the color I used when I was just starting, and you start out here and you pack it in and you don't have to reapply that much because if you put too much on the brush, like it's over, you're just gonna, it's not gonna work. Right. But so when you've added a new color, cause I've added a new color, you go back over the first color or the new color with the first one and just kind of like dab to pack the shadow.
So you're picking
and
up
then
some
blend.
Of what you had already put on.
Exactly.
Okay.
Exactly.
That makes sense.
And so then you do that for each step that you go down. For each color that you decide to use to blend with, you go back over.
Pixie says that they love the sparkles, but also can't do wing liner for their life because they've shrunken eye. Sunken. I can't read.
I was like,
shrunken.
Pixie, sorry,
Pixie.
I'm sorry.
But like different liner styles are like totally appropriate for different like eye shapes and
absolutely
whatever. And like you just find whatever works for you. There's a period in my life where I really wished that I could do like the liner all the way around, like not like Avril Lavigne heavy, but like
speak for yourself,
like, just enough. And I just like can't make it work. My eyes like are not cooperative in that regard.
What eye shape do you have, would you say?
They're almondy, I don't know, but like I get pretty like
round.
If I like go like deer in the headlights. I'm a very squinty person naturally, and I've had multiple directors yell at me to like open your goddamn eyes, Elena.
You're like it's just
stop
my
singing
face.
Like this.
But maybe you're excited. Okay, and so just another quick moment. Now I'm gonna go in with this like lighter sparkly shade right above this dark one, which I just used with a flat brush, a little tiny guy like this. So you can, again, take on some pigment and then delicately apply. Okay. And see, look, isn't that nice?
Yeah.
It's nice.
I like it.
I was just fixing spelling mistakes that I made.
How could you?
I spelt Maaerys wrong.
I mean, I like noticed, but I didn't want to say anything.
I also noticed, but then I didn't want to be wrong.
No.
I was like, did I miss something? Did like Liz have an apostrophe for coolness in her name that I just didn't know about?
No, that was just me, and I got DMs. I was like, oh shit, yeah, fix in now. So I just do it on Photoshop.
So back to our story. Claire, how do you feel about the development of Maaerys and Giswaldo?
I adore both of them.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, Maaerys is my bestie for life.
Yes.
I also like somewhat had a crush on her many years ago, but like,
oh God, she never knew.
But like, it's okay, you know, that's over and done with. My heart has moved on. No, but like, I definitely thought very poorly of Giswaldo at the start.
Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. But over the course of our adventures together, I came to trust him a lot. And so that's why the whole, like, you know, turn evil, betray us to Strahd.
Oh my God.
Hurtful.
That was devastating. Like,
here's this person that I've like opened my soul to and told basically like my most horrific moments of my life.
Mm-hmm.
And now he's gone off and been an ass, but like in a really bad way. TLDR, I adore both of you. Starting a relationship in the midst of like this sort of crisis is questionable.
You're like, I have questions.
Shared trauma can be the basis for a relationship. Not always the best way to start something. So, you know, just it's a little bit of a cautionary, like, maybe when this is all over, like, do a check.
Is it?
Just make sure.
Oh my God, I love that.
I like Pixie's comment.
Oh, what'd you say?
I actually cried during that confrontation.
Aww.
There were a lot of emotions that day.
There were.
Yeah.
They were running high.
Alarmus was just happy to see it all burn. No, he wasn't really. He's a softie, really.
You're concerning.
Well, I gotta say that Liz thought Alarmus was half elf up until I just told her no, he's human.
Wait, really?
For some reason, I can't explain why. It's been so long since we've gone over everything.
He's a human.
I know. I knew it. I knew he was at least half. Yeah.
What am I?
You're a human.
Yes, I am.
Paladin. And he is a half elf mage.
Well,
and
mage.
Are they different?
Hang on a minute. Yeah. You questioned the mage bit and not the half elf bit.
Wait, but are they different?
You just called me a half elf again.
God damn mage, it! He's a human wizard.
There you go. Mage is in a class.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Well,
but his last name
is in AD&D.
Well, yes, in AD&D it is. And then there's like shit in Pathfinder, like the Magus, which is like its own interesting situation.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also a warlock.
Oh yeah, that's right.
And I'm a baby dragon now.
Yeah, you do. I talked about that in my little video that I made of this, like, the extended edition of this Luke. Oh, also, so I'm doing what's called a half cut crease, and so in order to do that, because I'll put glitter here and then a lighter shade on the very inside, and so then it'll make a nice delineation between what I've already blended out. Mm-hmm. But in order to do that, like, it's weird, and I never thought that this would be the case, but you should put concealer on your crease and just follow the natural curvature of the lid. So
interesting.
Yeah.
And
it's like, it looks super intimidating, but with the right tools, this is just a concealer brush. You can do it.
Okay. Wait, so what exactly are you putting on there then?
Currently?
Yeah.
Just concealer. It's like the same stuff I use under my eyeballs.
Oh, okay. Max wants to know if you help with makeup when you're on stage as well.
I do, actually. I have worked in the costume and wig department / helping with makeup at my school. So yeah, I have some costuming and makeup experience as well. And I grew up, whoopsie, it's fine. We'll blend it out. I grew up dancing. So I've always been having to like help other people with their makeup and have other people help me. So
depending on the like resources of either a school or theater companies, they are not necessarily going to do all of your makeup. So most singers end up having to do a lot of their own makeup for performance.
And hair prep. It's important and hair prep. To know.
You'll get wig, but you have to do like all your pin curls. You usually have to do your base layers. And then they'll only go in and help you if you have like really specific shit, like old people makeup.
Right.
Which Liz might have more experience with than me.
Oh my God, I've been old so many times. I'm like, I've not been old. It's just my voice type. It's like, because I sing mezzo soprano, and my voice, like I have a lower voice, and so it's like they just think it's like, oh well, only old ladies have low voices. And I'm like, what about sultry ladies? Or just like general ladies? I don't know.
Well, that's also discounting all of like the really really high voiced old ladies that sing in choirs.
Have you been in a church choir? So now we're gonna put some glitter on the eye, and I'm using this. And the best thing to do for a glitter application is to just put it on your finger. And when you put the concealer on your eye, it makes the crease, but also it's tacky. So it, I wish my camera, there it is. It just sticks better. And I just do like a couple applications, a couple layers. Just dabbing it on the eyeball.
I don't know how you can, I mean, obviously women get used to obviously putting makeup on, but obviously the first time I had makeup on was for our Halloween thing.
And yes.
When you did Jax.
Well, that as well as obviously my wife put black around his eyes and stuff. Yeah. Oh my God. It was like tickling. I was just like, I can't. I mean, I've put contacts in before and stuff like that. I don't need glass or contacts, but I've worn colored contacts, and like obviously with Jax I wore yellow ones, so that doesn't bother me. But when she was like putting that brush across my obviously my eyelids and that, I was like, oh my God, that's bloody horrible. Not as in painful, but just tickly horrible.
I vividly remember, in spite of my bad memory, the first time that anyone tried to put mascara on me was in 8th grade. And we were doing this project where you had to like dress up as some historical figure and then like give a presentation as them. And one of my classmates came in and did my makeup, and I just like, they came at me with the brush, and I just like was backing up. Like, no, don't do this to me.
Oh my God. That's never what you want to hear. Like regarding a makeup application, they just came at me with a brush. It's like, no. You want to go gently talk to them. Wait. Know what's coming.
Pixie mentioned Cats on Broadway, which if you're saying the VHS, I think you're talking about the I don't remember which year it is, but it's like
I love the VHS.
It was probably like the 90s. And I fucking love it.
Me too.
Because I
I always wanted to be the white cat that had the dance solo. <too. laughs> That's my best impression. There we go.
I used to want to be the white cat when I was like really little, and then I graduated to wanting to be the one who sang the cavity.
Oh yeah. And the cavity.
Yeah. I was lucky not to work cats twice. I'm not quite sure how to parse your cat's comment.
I like that there's a cat's comment.
Thanks for the sub, guys. I'm surprised my daughter would want to watch, because she loves makeup. She's only 11.
Oh, yeah.
That's what she got for Christmas. She just wanted makeup.
I mean, I am 30, and that's all I wanted for Christmas.
All I want for Christmas
is a color palette. Is a block palette. Okay, so now I can finally, I think, start putting on.
Oh no, we have missed opportunities today. No worries, Ugluck.
We do, yeah. No,
doing a little intro. Maybe we're gonna recap eventually.
No, we should. Let's recap.
Oh, lucky enough to work cats twice. That's dope. I would love to see what that show looks like backstage.
Probably incredible.
That was my mom's favorite in theater.
What's up, girl?
That was my mom's favorite in theater, was Cats.
It's so good.
It really is.
You want to start recapping?
I guess.
Let's hit him with a recap.
What? How far back are we going?
Oh my God. I actually would love to go back to the very beginning.
Good place to start.
And I think I'll leave my foundation like this. What do you think?
It's a choice. It's a strong choice.
I'm all about strong choices. Okay, great. Okay, so yes, our party, we have Acantha, who is what, a halfling?
That's a good question.
She's a gnome.
She's a gnome? Okay.
Yeah. Claire, did you not know either?
Yeah.
I had a little brain.
Now I feel like less of a douche. I'm so sorry. It's like, it's not because I don't care. It's just because like, I can't remember. Okay.
She's a forest gnome.
Okay, yeah. So she's a forest gnome and she's our druid. She likes to be a snake. It's V cute. Yeah. Her heart's it's like, I think her heart is even purer than Maaerys's heart.
She is purity ensconced in a small body. You're a little contaminated with all the sangria.
Never enough. And then
never enough.
We have Jeswaldo, I know he's a human and I know he's a rogue. and he recently stopped being evil, which we were all like very stoked about.
That was a good time. Lot of stress about that. And you know, massive props to Sean for playing the descent like perfectly.
So good.
Yeah.
And then we have me. I'm Maaerys. For those of you who don't know, I died. It was very traumatic for me. And
for me.
And for Claire, my best friend. And I am a cleric half-elf. I at least know my own shit. That would be really bad.
You're a cleric half-elf?
Half-elf cleric. And then we have Cyborg, who, okay, so both Acantha and Cyborg came on to the team when I was gone. So that's when I came true. Back, I was like, who are these wonderful new people? So yes. Cyborg is also human.
Yes.
And he's a monk.
Hey.
Come in.
Child of Jade.
I can't see you. Hang on. come on. You got to get used to it. She's going to be on stream. She loves makeup. She's going to be on stream next month, aren't you?
Oh, yay.
They're playing, come here, say hello. Brilliant. We're playing Stranger Things. She's looking forward to playing D&D.
That's
super exciting.
Can you come say hello or what? So you're still being silly. The other one over there, she don't care. You want to say enough. Hello? No.
Oh, Sean's on.
Oh, Sean's on.
Hi, Sean.
Yay.
Well, perfect timing.
Is he? I can't see him. Where is he?
No, he's in chat.
Oh, he's in chat.
Oh, no. All the things got screwy. Jade, fix the cameras.
Oh, it's because Peter took his camera away.
Damn it, Peter.
Fix it, Peter.
He says oops in chat.
Damn it, Peter. Right, so I died. It was traumatic. I came back. Thanks, Jeswaldo. Let's see. And then Athelflad is our half-elf, like me, and she's a ranger, right?
I think she wishes she was an elf.
Athelflad's
she's got, like, weird
Asimir.
Issues.
Azamar.
What is that?
Effervlad's an Azamar.
No, she's not.
I think she's a ranger. Oh my God, stop, Jade! Okay, and then we have Claire and Elimus here, and I know that I have already messed up, so if you would like to introduce your characters again, I'll let you do that.
I am a padlock, paladin warlock.
I was like, what does that mean?
Yeah. And my patron, as we've like finally fucking figured out, is what's his face? Argenthost. Because that's fucking dope.
Hell yeah.
A silver dragon that had a group of knights in Barovia, like way the fuck back. And then he died.
He died.
Yeah. We had to go through the painstaking effort of getting his massive fucking skull out of Stroud's castle.
And how did we do that, Claire? I don't remember, but because I like the story.
Well, so that was part of the whole Casimir Petrina debacle. Because we promised Casimir the Dusk Elf to get his sister out of catacombs.
Right.
And so we brought her back. She was all banshee'd. And then
what a nice girl.
She's an interesting lady.
Sucked.
Yes, Ugluck, I did declare my true feelings. But like I said earlier, my heart has moved on. There is another light of my eye, so to speak.
Is it Alimus?
Later. No.
Oh. Ooh,
I have already firmly established that I do not swing in that direction.
Yeah, I was joking.
Alimus is like, when is someone going to love me? It comes up too often for it to not be based in, like, Alimus really is looking for love.
Talking
this is
about
like the Bachelor
Sivor,
for Alimus.
I've just finished Sivor's art.
Oh my god, it looks so good.
It's really fucking good.
It's glad how it come out. Still.
Yeah. He's also very wholesome.
Oh my god, so sweet.
There's so many beautiful personalities in this party.
Beautiful souls.
TLDR, Petrina teleported us out with the skull, and then we had to carry it to Argenvost Holtz on Akatha's neck. So just like
a
massive neck with the dragon skull on its head. I want art of that.
Yes, me too. We need art.
It doesn't
of
have
that.
To be like super good, just like cute art.
We need fan art.
Yeah. If anyone has drawing skills. I don't. Yeah. I can like sort of draw, but like only if things aren't moving. Don't forget the giant. Oh my god.
Oh my god, that was so such drama.
He's in this one.
So we ran into a one-eyed giant.
As one does.
Would be a cyclops, probably. If we're getting like really fucking specific about it.
Which we know I'm not. I think everyone's a half elf.
Pixie, finish your character art and then you can draw as a contest deck. That's fine. It was like sick and had the body of its friend who was like in the last stages of the vampire curse.
Wait, was it his friend or his son? I thought it was his son.
Oh, I thought it was his friend.
His friend. Or brother. Yeah. It might be
his
brother.
I mean, that's a matter of interpretation.
Peter said it was his
son.
It was his son? Oh my god. Well, you know.
Yeah,
what?
Peter, did you lie to me?
Definitely his child. Wow, I did not understand.
Definitely
that.
His child.
Little Lulu says that.
That's my daughter.
Really?
Yeah, that's how I'm gonna that's my nickname for a little Lulu.
Oh,
that's your daughter.
Yeah.
That's so fucking cute. So there's the his name was Vigfor, and then like Zegfor or something like that. And he like came in clutch when we were restorming Argenvost Halt, and you know helped us not die to things. It was like a whatchamacallit cavalry moment.
Da 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 da. No.
Da da da.
Okay, so I still need. This is entirely for me, selfishly.
Oh,
I still need to know. So what was the deal with Irina? Because it happened so long ago.
Okay.
So she was Tatiana reincarnated.
Yes.
But hadn't he like also tried to like her soul kept being reincarnated and it just happened to be Irene. Okay, yeah, run me through that again. It was all very convoluted in my brain.
The issue with Barovia is that when you die, your soul doesn't get to pass to the beyond. It stays in like a pool of like hell, which you've been to. And you know, when a little bab is born, the souls basically climb on top of each other to get out of this like limbo hell, to be reincarnated into whatever got born. So this has happened to Tatiana, OG, a couple times. We know it was Irena. We think there was we know there was another one in the village of Berez. We just haven't been there. I really want to go to Berez because it sounds like there's some interesting shit down there, but we're kind of on the clock now, so we might have to like maybe do a little like country tour after we defeat Strahd, if we defeat Strahd, and like, you know, wrap up some loose ends. But
also, not to distract too much, but I'm about to do my wing liner for Pixie, and so just to like, again, like follow the shape of your own eye. That's the best advice I can give. But if you find the tip of your brow between here and here, you just do a little dot. And again, tip or like tail of brow. Boop. And then, let me actually look at the mirror. It would be real sad if I fucked this up. So basically, you just connect your dots and you draw in and fill in. Okay, go on, Claire.
What was I saying? Oh, Strahd loves Tatiana. Tatiana keeps getting reincarnated. Oh, she killed herself, by the way, because she was supposed to marry Sergei.
Right, father. Yes, that was such
a. And she threw herself off the balcony to her death. That was where we saw Strahd the second time that we went in. So yeah, she died. And so every time she keeps popping up, reincarnated, he's like, maybe I can get that.
Right. Okay. And so then in Kresk, some like real sketchy shit was also happening. So we met Kresk. Yeah, go ahead.
Well, Jeswaldo was being nice Jeswaldo.
Yay.
And like listening to Irina's feelings and hearing that like she felt like there was something in Kresk that was like happy or comfortable more so than anywhere else in Barovia. And then we took her to that like holy pool and she touched the water and then went inside and never came out. And we saw the spirits of Tatiana and Sergei finally being reunited and then passing on, we think.
Who knows?
Yeah.
See, it would seem that way. Yeah. But here's another mind thing for you then. You know the little girl that we saved from the river?
Yes.
The daughter of thing. Apparently her soul is something important as well.
Like
a big character. How do you know that? Literally just research. And stuff I knew from the past. It's the stuff I knew from the past. It was just things I remember.
I'm trying really hard to keep like.
I didn't say who. I know who, but I didn't say who.
No, out of game knowledge.
I don't research nothing like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, this was purely something I knew from the past.
And I research nothing,
including your spells.
Including my spells. Whee!
And what race we all are.
Including that.
And what level we are.
90. Thank you. All right, so. So we're talking, yeah, what about the auto? It's been a while.
Oh, auto? Oh my God.
We talked about auto. We loved auto. Some of us more than
let's
others.
Let's talk about the Abbey.
Yeah, it was crazy.
It was really, really creepy. So in the Abbey at Kresk, we met a bunch of like mongrel folk. So they're people who seem to be like humans crossed with other animals. And they're all family. They all have the last name Bellevue. And Ethelflaed is like really into auto. Don't really know what that's about, but you know, everyone.
You like what you like. We're not here to yuck anyone's
yums.
No.
We're not gonna do that.
We're not here
to shame anyone. But there was also the abbot who was like trying to, oh God, I wonder what happened with that. he was trying to make like a flesh golem version,
yes,
of Tatiana to, yeah, pass off to Strahd.
It's fucking weird.
And needed a wedding dress. And so you remember when we left Kresk and we went back to Valaki, we went with the wife of the burgomaster from Kresk.
Yes.
And she was there to pick up a wedding dress to bring back. Lord knows if that happened.
Fucking weird.
And if the abbot's suddenly going to show up with like a pseudo Tatiana.
Well, let's hope so. Keep it spicy.
Yes. From the house that we burned, there was a wedding dress in a house that Gesualdo/Opperson/Sean did some recon in, and that recon involved setting the house on fire.
Yeah!
As we do.
I'm sorry, are we really adventurers? That's the one thing I do know we are, is adventurers.
I think we might be crossed with arsonists.
Nah.
For the number of things that we've burned down.
It's adventurous.
We're on like 3+ structures that have experienced fire because of
first session, wasn't it? First session.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh yeah.
We set fire to a house in the village of Barovia and then had to put it out so we didn't burn down the rest.
Burning the down the house. Then we went to the Amber Temple and that was very traumatic.
Yeah.
I died?
Shit happened. Yeah.
I don't know if like
you died.
I died.
Grew wings. I met Mads Mikkelsen.
Yes, Mads.
I done Scyvol with and without the wings, and Ryan's like, I hope he never loses them. I was like, okay.
I know, they're so cool.
Yeah, definitely. That felt like a really great, like, midline ability change, like, adjustment for him, you know? Where, like, it's a good boon. It's also a really interesting and freaky consequence that's totally in line with the setting and, you know, like, is manageable, but also...
Yeah, also, like, shout out to Peter. His world building is so good.
He's definitely taking advantage of what the module provides.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, Pixie, we did also get a ewer. it's attached to Maaerys at the hip.
Pretty much.
They're basically the same person now. We could get much more drunk as a party.
Right now, Maaerys is the only one. It's so disappointing. Yeah.
A firkin was the other word that Peter taught us. Thank you, Sean.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think it came up in this game. It was in my other game with Sean that we were talking about, like, the size of, like, alcohol barrels. And there's, like, a chart with all of, like, the weird English names for them. The only one that I ever remember is Hogshead, but they're, like, really, really... specific names for, yes, is that butt or like boot?
Butte?
I don't know. A buttload is an actual term of measurement. You know, I did not know that.
What? Nuh-uh.
Okay, short you. I'm learning so much from chat.
Yes.
Oh my God. Such beautiful eyes.
Thanks.
The fodor, that was the word that I was thinking of. Fodor, it's fodor, right? Someone telling me if I'm pronouncing it. Fooder. Okay, I was
wrong. Oh, fooder.
Okay, see, that's not, looking at that constellation of letters, that's not how I would have thought to say that, but you know.
It's like booter. No, just me. I guess so. Well, damn.
Ugh, boy, oh boy.
Chelsea's struggling to get on the internet.
Aww.
Just gotta wait for Adam to come home.
I will say one of the highlights of my week is that I finally have stable internet and I'm getting all of the download speed that I'm actually paying for.
Nice.
That's awesome. Did it take that long for them to set it up?
I have been fighting with Comcast and my building management for 6 months.
That is so frustrating.
Yeah.
Especially like with the pandemic, you're in school, like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Is Coke a new sponsor? Is someone drinking
Coke? LOL. Sorry, it's me. Yes. Coke, ColourPop.
Comcast is.
Who's only sponsor, Emily?
They're definitely not sponsoring us today.
Pepsi. We're sponsored by Pepsi, apparently.
But yeah, we were paying for 600 down and we were getting like 6 to 60.
Oh my God.
And then there were basically like every 5 minutes, either a drop or a blip in the signal strength.
That's so shitty.
Yeah. Pixie, I completely understand that.
What'd she say?
So, I spent years thinking epitome and they're spelling it two different ways. E-P-I-T-O-M-E, epitome, and E-P-I-T-I-M-Y were different words, probably like epitome or something.
Right.
Like that,
yes.
Funny story. So, when I was a wee lass, I adored the movie Kiki's Delivery Service.
So good.
I mean, I'm a massive Miyazaki fan. I just threw my pen.
Peter, you can take your phone.
But that was like my favorite when I was the young one. Oh no, the cameras are all screwy. Hello, Teresa.
Hello.
So there's the English dub version of the songs. But then my dad also showed me the original Japanese intro song and ending song. And one of them has an English title, the Japanese song, which is Enveloped by Tenderness. But Lena read that as enveloped.
Of course.
And even to this day, I still have trouble reading the word enveloped as not enveloped. Because it's so deep in my brain that that's how I'm supposed to pronounce it. So
I think that's fair.
Past me.
I also read it as enveloped for a really long time. Mm-hmm. I also, when Harry Potter first came out, which is like our generation, mm-hmm. I thought Hermione was spelled like macaroni, like it sounded like macaroni. So I read it Hermione for like a very long time until I saw the freaking movies and I was like, oh my God, I am horrified. It was awful.
Really funny.
Jade, where's your makeup?
Mine's already on. Hang on.
Is it?
Hang on.
Looks so good. He's doing a very natural look today.
Hang on.
Love it.
Oh yeah.
This color.
Jade, are we taking a break before the game?
I'm literally going to jump straight over to it so people can join whenever.
Well,
that is the best Jade. You have ever looked. Oh my God,
Jade, you look amazing.
Eyebrows on fleek.
Yes,
on fleek.
I wouldn't make any changes.
Yeah.
Why is it?
Yes.
So, Liz, you spent the last like hour and a half doing your makeup, and it took Jade like a hot second.
Yeah. I know, and he
a
looks
hot
better
pink
than
second.
Me.
One second.
Well, cool.
Yeah, we should.
Yeah, thanks for those of you who joined us today for Makeup with Maaerys and crew. It was super funsies. If you have any questions about what I did to my face during the stream, feel free to ask.
Oh my God, Jade.
And great. All right. Jade looks amazing. He also did his makeup.
It very much complements your background. Yeah. That does not.
No, I think that. Oh, look, I love yes, it. I love that.
Do oh it God. Always.
Yeah. So he's going to be wearing that in stream.
I'm Gesualdo.
And he looks
now.
Great.
You do look like Halloween Gesualdo.
Oh, goodness gracious.
All right. Well, yeah. We'll see y'all soon.
Well, we're live literally soon, so.
Yeah, literally so soon.
Don't go anywhere.
Yeah, so yeah, anywhere. We're staying live, guys. So just, yeah, just I know you can probably not take me seriously right now. Yeah.
What? You look so good.
I know. Why can't I tell you?
Oh,
there
my
we go.
God. Oh, my God. You look so
good. Hang on, guys. other people joining. So I'm going to change it to the next scene. So don't go anywhere, guys. We'll be live soon. So see you in a bit.
Gotta fix my friggin' eyelash. Okay. Bye.
I'll see you in a sec.